Hello everyone, you're welcome back to Bioscience Class Channel. Today is another lesson and we are going to treat a biochemical compound called lipid. So today we are going to treat lipid and we are going to talk about the structure of lipids. We are going to talk about the composition. We are going to talk about their polarity, their solubility, the types of lipids, I mean their classification, and we will finally talk about the role they play in our biological systems. All right, so for lipids, they are a diverse group of biological substances that are composed of carbon, oxygen, and hydrogen. So the chemical composition for lipids is elements such as carbon, oxygen, and hydrogen. Okay, so they are primarily or exclusively made of non-polar groups. So when you take the structure of lipid, they are made of non-polar groups, so they cannot interact or dissolve a water. All right, so they cannot dissolve in water, so they readily dissolve in non-polar solvents. So because they cannot be dissolved in water, we have to dissolve them in non-polar solvents. So for example, we can use ethanol, or we can generalize them as alcohols. All right, so we can use alcohol or chloroform in order to dissolve lipid molecules. All right, so lipid is a combination of fats and oil, so we can break lipids down to fats and oil. All right, as we know already, lipid is made up of fats and oil. So we have some classifications of lipid, and example of them include terpenes. So we have terpene, which is made up of isoprene units that we are going to be talk about in the next slide. All right, so stay tuned. We also have steroid. So these are anabolic compounds that is a precursor for many hormones. All right, so we are also going to talk about it in the next slide. We also have fats, we have waxes, we have phosphatids, we have cerebrosides, we have an other derived lipid compound. So we can derive many compounds from lipids, and we also have some natural sources of lipids, and these are those I've mentioned. We also have eicosanoids. Okay, so we will talk about them into details in our next video. All right. Okay, so we have lipids. They combined with protein and carbohydrate to constitute the principal structural components of all cell membranes. So when you take a structure of a cell membrane, they are made up of biomolecules such as carbohydrates. We have proteins, and lipid is one of them. So lipids also serve as a function in the cell membrane, of which we are going to talk about it. So they play also a vital role in the absorption of fat soluble vitamins, and these fat soluble vitamins include vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, and vitamin K. So during digestion, lipids in the body helps to absorb fat soluble vitamins from food substances. All right, so they also give the body insulation against extreme cold. So during cold condition, lipids help the body to provide warmth. All right, so the hair follicles in the surface of the skin, there are lipids there. So during extreme cold condition, this follicles helps to provide warmth, and we have a process called homeostasis. So the balance in the body, all these processes are as a result of lipids. All right, okay. We also have some major roles of lipids in our biological system, and as I've already talked about it, they serve as a structural component of the biological membrane. So the structure of a cell membrane, lipid is made of it. So we have a lipid in the cell membrane, which serves a purpose of insulation. All right, and also it helps partial absorption of substances in and out of the cell. So it allows certain substances to pass through and block others. All right. So they also provide energy reserves. So lipids provide energy reserves. As I've already talked about it, they absorb vitamins from food substances during digestion. So this energy that is being absorbed are stored in the form of triacylglycerols. All right. So triacylglycerols is TAC, and we will talk about TACs during our next videos. We will take the classification of lipids one by one, so they are all going to be elaborated. All right. So the third function is both lipid and lipid derivatives serves as vitamins and hormones. So as I've already talked about it, lipids absorb vitamins and also they serve as hormones. So hormones derivatives. So we have the classification of lipid. We have one as steroid. So steroids are the precursor for some hormones in our body. All right, we have cholesterol and all those hormones, they have a lipid precursor, so they serve as lipid derivatives. All right, and lipophilic bile acid also aid in lipid solubilization. So before lipids can be solubilized, we need lipophilic bile acid, and this also helps to solubilize lipid in the body. Okay, so let's move on to classification of lipids. So you can see here we've grouped our lipids into categories. So we have one, fatty acids, and for the fatty acids we have saturated fatty acids and we have unsaturated fatty acid. So for the saturated fatty acid, they are made up of no conjugated pi bonds. So there are no conjugated pi bonds in saturated fatty acid. Whilst unsaturated fatty acids, they are made up of conjugated pi bonds. So we have double bonds in these fatty acids, which makes them unsaturated. Okay, so we also have glycerides. We have neutral glycerides and we have phospholipids. So phospholipids, they are made up of phosphate groups. So phosphate groups are attached to these lipid molecules. We also have non-glyceride. So for non-glyceride, we have sphingolipids and we have steroids. So anabolic steroids. So this is a precursor for certain hormones. And we also have waxes. So waxes, they are also made up of fatty acids. So they have an acidic functional group over there. So we will talk about them later into very detailed in our next video. The fourth classification is also complex lipid. So for complex lipid, we have lipoproteins. And for the lipoproteins, we have so many types. We have very low density lipoproteins. We have low density lipoproteins and etc. So we will talk about them one by one and we will treat them into details. We also have glycolipid. So glycolipid is also under complex lipid. So fifth one, we also have eicosanoids. So eicosanoids are also a precursor for some drug compounds such as aspirin and all those chemical compounds. They are a source of lipids. So we'll take them one by one in our next video to talk about them into detail. So basically, this is an introduction about lipids. And if this is the first time you are watching this channel, make sure to subscribe, like, and if you have any question, give it in the comment section and we will attend to it. Kindly stay focused and watch our next video, of which we are going to talk about this classification into very detail. All right, have a nice day and don't forget to hit the subscribe button so that we get alert when any video drops. All right, have a nice day.